We are before God.
Tuli maso ga Katonda.
Whatever you have sinned against God,
buli kibi kyokoze Katonda,
ask him to forgive you.
Musaba akusonyiwe.
Remember, you wake up to do it right.
Jukira ogolokoka kola birungi byerere.
And you end up doing all wrong.
N'okomekereza nga byonna obikoze mbukyamu.
Ask him now.
Kale nno musabe.
In Jesus.
Linjere Yesu tusabye.
Our topic today.
Omutwe gwaffe gwa leero.
With faith.
N'okukkiriza.
Pick up your banner.
Situla bendera yo.
Your enemy is defeated.
Omulabe wo awanguddwa.
I'm reading Judges 7.
Nsoma ekyabalamuzi essula ya musanvu.
Verse 14. Then his companion answered and said,
munene addamu n'ayogera nti,
this is nothing else but the sword of Gideon, the son of Eliash.
Ekyo si kirala wabula ekitale kya Gideoni mutabani wa Yowasi omusajja wa Isirayiri.
A man of Israel, into his hand God has delivered Midian and the whole camp.
Mu mukono gw'oyo Mukama Katonda mwagabudde Abamidiyaani n'eggye lyo lyonna.
And so it was when Gideon had the telling of the dream.
Awo lwatuuka Gideoni bwe yamuwulira.
And its interpretation.
N'abuulira ekirooto n'okutegeeza kwakyo n'asinza.
He returned to the camp of Israel and said,
n'addayo mu lusiisira lwa Isirayiri n'ayo.
Arise, for the Lord has delivered the camp of Midian into your hand.
Mugolokoke kubanga Mukama agabudde mu mukono gwammwe eggye ly'Abamidiyaani.
And so it was when Kakande heard the telling of the dream and its interpretation.
Kakande bwe yawulira ekirooto n'amakulu gaakyo.
That he worshipped.
N'asinza.
And return to the camp of the Ugandan.
N'addayo mu lusiisira lw'abanna Uganda.
To the camp of the believers.
Lusiisira lw'abakkiriza.
And said,
n'abagamba nti,
arise,
mugolokoke,
for the Lord has delivered the camp of the devils into your hand.
Kubanga Mukama agabudde olusiisira lw'abalabe bammwe mikono gyammwe.
What did Jesus do?
Ki Yesu kye yakola?
On the cross at Calvary,
ku musalaba ekalivaliyo,
he went to the place of pain.
Yagenda butereevu mu kifo kiri eky'obulumi.
He planted a banner of victory.
N'asimbawo bendera y'obuwanguzi.
He has now packed banners of victories.
Kati apakinze bendera z'obuwanguzi. Ezijjudde obuwanguzi obwereere mu buli kimu ekibadde kikuteganya.
It now needs you
kati kikwetaagisa
gwe
otoole ebendera y'obuwanguzi eya Yesu ogisimbe mu kifo ky'omaze okuwamba.
In Jesus' name.
Linnya lya Yesu.
Next is Sister Tushabe Salama.
Tushabe Salama Ezeko.
She can't walk without support. This is severe pain in the loins. And she's even tying this cloth round the abdomen. Resulting from a disease of the kidney. She has the kidney stones.
I know we inja
munsigo. And the husband has to support her to get up. Because of the pain she's going through in the entire abdomen and in the back.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Mulinje ya Yesu Kristo.
Be
wonyezebwa.
Touched by God's power.
Kwatidwa kamanyika Katonda.
Father, forgive her.
Chitafe musonywe.
Lord, for the salvation of
us. Mukama kulobulokozi bw'omwoyo gwe.
Rise up.
Situka nyabo.
For you are free.
Kubanga oli waddembe.
Thank you, Jesus. Watch the lady standing upright. She's now removing the cloth that has been tied around the abdomen.
There is another man who is dark.
Waliwo omusajja omulala naye ng'ono muddugavu.
And you are accusing him of your failures.
Era omuvunaana okulemererwa kwo.
And when you see this man with no money.
Era buli lw'otunuulira omusajja ono nga talina ssente.
You always crumble in your heart and say, I wouldn't have been with this man. Because the situation is not good.
Bulijjo weemulugunya mu mutima gwe n'ogamba sandibadde na musajja ono kuba embeera si nnungi. Musajja ki ono omulala?
Amanya gange bambita Tushabe Salama.
I'm called Tushabe Salama.
Omusajja gwa Katonda kyayogedde
kikulu. What the man of God has said is true.
Omusajja gwayogeddeko mumanyi.
I know the man he has talked about.
Kati oyo musajja yali mudugavu.
That man was dark.
Mwamvu kw'okusinga ono.
And taller than my husband. He's slim. He's not so big. What happened was I was barren for 6 years. I could not produce a child, so I spent with him 6 years. But I ran away from his home. He didn't know he had gone to
In
work.
In the dream, you see him when he has found you and he has come to fight you to sleep with you.
Naye mu kirooto omuloota ng'olaba akuzudde era ng'azze okulwana naawe yeebake naawe. Man of God, what you've said is true.
And even before all that pain, you saw him.
Ne bwe wali tonnafuna bulumi obwo wamulaba.
This is why you have all this pain.
Ero y'ensonga lwaki olina obulumi buno bwonna mu lubuto.
Omusajja wa Katonda ayogedde ekituufu lwali lwokutaano wiiki ewedde.
Man of God, what you've said is true. It was last Friday.
Ne muloota mu kirooto nga ngamba ti olowooza oti wantoloka tonaba kuntoloka kasita nze paka wadde myaka meka nja kukufuna nanze namugamba saga kati nali nyambadde nga tonatwala kwemu.
So he told me in the dream that you thought you had run away from me. I told him that I have gone, I will not come back. And he told me that even if it will take how many years, you'll be mine. So I was putting on shoes, then he took one of my shoes. Then after that, I started feeling pain in my kidney.
Stop thinking about that man.
Lekera okuloza kumsajja oyo.
Have you heard of a woman called Mama Habari?
Wali owulidde ku mukyala ayitibwa Mama Habari?
Oyo Mama Habari mumanyiko.
I know her.
Oyo Mama Habari twalipimba naye.
We used to sing together with Mama Habari. So she loved my husband. She used to love my husband and she could send me to him.
You dreamt a young boy of about 6 years.
Waloto omwana omuto w'obulenzi ngali mu myaka nga mukaaga.
And he is always standing in between here.
Era bulijjo mulaba ng'ayimiridde wakati wamwe.
He tried to hold him like a distance.
N'ogezaako mukwata omukono muzze eno.
Yes.
Kituufu.
Oyo mwana mulota nnyo.
I oftenly dream of that child and I tell my husband.
Waliote mulota ngali mu maaso gaffe. Luni ng'ebase ku lubuto lange atono n'ebakako wa.
At times I dream him standing before us. At times he is sleeping on my bed.
And the Lord told Gideon.
Mukama na gamba Gideon iti.
I have given you victory over this Midian.
Nkuwadde obuwanguzi ku Midiani
bano. But if you fear.
Naye bw'obanga otidde.
Go down to the camp.
Genda wansi eri mu
kisisira.
Ojja kuwulira omusajja ng'abuulira munne ekirooto.
Kakande.
Kakande.
I have given you victory over barrenness. If you fear,
Bobo Tidi,
you now go down to the church. You now hear the barren or what they have dreamed. The first one is the baby boy.
Asoka mwana wabulenzi.
And the tall baby girl.
Ate no mwana wobuwalanga mwavu ngagwe.
Thank you.
Glory be to God Almighty, who has got a better plan for our future. For many years, Lady Tusabe had suffered barrenness and given up all hope of ever having children. But through the prophetic message given to her by the man of God, Prophet Samuel Kakande, she was in position to pick up her victory banner as a mother among mothers. Be a witness to what God Almighty has done for her after the prayers of the anointed man of God, Prophet Samuel Kakande.
Yes, we was the Uganda.
Praise Jesus, brethren.
Amanya gange bambita Precious Tusabe Salama.
My name is Precious Tusabe Salama.
Amanya gange bambita Precious Tusabe Salama.
My name is Princess Tusabe Salama.
Okuvira Congo nze ndi mwana wakabaka kuva Congo.
From Congo, I'm a daughter to a king. I am a princess in Congo.
Ono Alice Saidi yange no ye mwami wange Katembo Ngahingahi.
Next to me is my husband, Mr. Katembo Ngahingahi.
Ono ali saidi eno muganda wange tugata batata ye Prince Katembo ava Congo.
And next to me is my brother called Prince. Katembo Nganayava Congo.
Ono ali saidi eno mulamu wange Muganda wa mwami wange.
And next is my in-law, the sister to my husband.
Bano babiri,
these
ne
two,
bano walala nono mwana, ba, bana bange.
And these others are my children.
Naze wano lwalero okuwa Yesu okujulira Yesu ebinene byakoze mu bulamu bwange.
I came here today to testify for the good things and great things Jesus has done in my life.
Nze kujawo wano najja n'ebizibu bingi nnyo nga byalemererwa mu nsi.
By the time I came here, I came with so many problems and I failed to get a solution in the whole world.
Nali nnyina bizibu bya kikulu kuto.
I had a problem of a hemorrhage.
Ganyina bizimba munabana.
I had uterine fibroids.
Ganyina seke za zibikira.
And my fallopian tubes were blocked.
Nze nali navunda vunda danze na mubiri mulamba.
I had already got rotten within me.
Na yeye obona tukano ku synagogue church wano kubiri.
Ewana
bi Samuel Kakande.
At the synagogue church of all nations at Prophet Samuel Kakande's church.
Nansabira.
The man of God prayed for me.
Naonezewa dala dala dala.
Totally got healed.
Paliwa maze kusabira. Nembulira mu rubuto ne luchankalanya.
After man of God praying for me, I felt something moving within my abdomen. I went to the toilet. Brethren, after the man of God praying for me, I felt some movement within my abdomen. I went to the toilet and this big fibroid came out.
I put
it on a toilet paper. I called my husband to photograph it. The first medical report proves that I had a kidney disease.
Praise Jesus, brethren.
Yes, we have as Wabo Luganda.
This is a medical form of Miss Tusabe Salama.
Eno ye baluwa ye dualido eyamu chala Tusabe Salama.
And this is a medical form from Kampala Imaging Center.
Ere baluwa enevamu Kampala Imaging Center.
Where the doctors examined her and they did an abdominal ultrasound scan.
Abasawa ebamu kebela nebakola scan ye yolubuto.
They found that she had stones, that is nephroliathis within the kidneys.
Nebazula ntaina mainja munsigo.
And she also had enlarged
kidneys.
And this is my other medical report that confirms that I had a complication of fallopian tube sickness at the same time fibroids in the uterus.
Brethren, here is also another medical form from Kampala Imaging Center. And this is an examination of the uterus and the fallopian tubes of Miss Tusabe Salama. And when they examined her, they found that she had multiple uterine fibroids. And also total blockage within the right fallopian tube. As well as narrowing within the left fallopian tube. Hence the problem of barrenness which she had.
That is when I met the chosen servant of God, Prophet Samuel Kakande. He prayed for me. I got healed as I've testified.
Nenda yo mudwaliro eriwe nyini nyini ngasagala kugenda walala baja njakuloza babuza buzibwa nenda yo eriwe nyini nyini.
I went back to the very hospital which initially checked me.
After banga ntono nenda yo ne basanganga nawonyezedwa barua ino ekakasa nawonye.
After a short time the doctors checked me and confirmed that I got healed. Here is the medical report.
Brethren, this is another examination from Kampala Imaging Center. Where the doctors examined her, our sister Miss Tusabe Salama. The doctors repeated the ultrasound scan. And this time when they repeated the scan to examine for any uterine fibroids, they found all her abdominal organs were normal. There were no muscles seen. And in conclusion, the doctors said that these are features of a normal uterus. And And brethren, that was after prayers by the man of God,
Prophet Samuel Kakande. I later realized that there is something wrong with my body. I was missing my periods. On reaching in Mengo Hospital, I went with my husband. The doctor told me, "Madam, we have seen that you are pregnant." In English, I said, "Wow."
Katia onenga bambera yangengeri mulabi na funa rubuto ngandi mukazi mukuru miaka ana mubiri.
I saw that I'm an old woman at the age of 42 to be pregnant. I decided to start my antenatal care very early.
Kati barua ya antenatal bachala mumanyingeri omuntu tosobola nyo dagala lya antenatal ngatoli rubuto. Barua yino.
Brethren, ladies, you know when you're pregnant, you should have the antenatal care. You cannot take this unless you're pregnant. Here is the medical report to confirm.
Here is the antenatal card of Miss Tusabe Salama.
Abaluganda eno ye card ya antenatal mchala no mchala Tusabe Salama kwa
ni. And it is an antenatal card from Mengo Hospital.
An antenatal card okuva mu dwaliro lye Mengo.
Ngandina rubuto ekifanani kichino.
When I was
ekikakasa nafuna rubuto.
Here is the photograph to prove to you that moment when I was pregnant.
Olubuto luno safuna mo bizibu byona.
I didn't get any complication during my pregnancy period.
Na time yatuka ne zalo mwana wobulenzi yono Shadrach.
I produced a baby boy. Here he is. This is baby Shadrach. Clap for Jesus.
Katukubira Yesu mungalo. Ono baby Shadrach ayo mwana go wobunabi ebagamba ndizala mwana asoka mulenzi yono Shadrach ne rinya lya muweba ne prophet Samuel Kakande ngagamba mwana oyo ye Shadrach.
This is the baby Shadrach. This is the miracle baby that I produced after the prayers of the man of God. And he's the boy whom the man of God prophesied about, that I'll produce a baby boy first. And the prophet is the one who named him the name Shadrach.
What are all this we see?
Yes,
praise Jesus, brethren. We were here in prayer. When Prophet Kakande had called upon the barren people to pray for them, I was in that service. This is what Prophet Kakande said. He said, each and every barren person who will produce or who will conceive is going to get a visa and an air ticket.
A journey to Dubai for three days.
During a special service on which Prophet Samuel Kakande called upon the barren for prayer, he promised to offer a free air ticket and visa to Dubai for them with their miracle babies. And these were his words.
God does nothing without his word. Barrenness must not be a new ministry. Our agreement was if you conceive, you bring his baby, we give you free ticket to Dubai, and 3 days in Dubai.
It came to pass. What Prophet Kakande promised us. He gave us 3 air tickets. As you're watching here. This is my air ticket and a visa. You can clearly see my name, Katembo Ngahingai. This is the 2nd air ticket. In the name of baby Shadrach. And here is the 3rd ticket. In the name of Princess Tusabe Salama.
Yes.
Here are the photographs. When we are in the aeroplane, you can see baby Shadrach. Whoever goes to Dubai. There is that dancing fountain and singing fountain. Where there is the tallest building. We were at the boat.
Yes.
mwawulidde wali nali mugumba.
You heard I told you I was barren.
Obuzibu bw'obugumba bwange bwali buvira ewaffe mu bakabaka.
The origin of my barrenness originated from the kingdom.
Ku kipande kyange sawandikako bugumba kasita eri nali nazalibwa ne mu mbeera zange zonna nga manyi tuli bagumba te sijja kuzaala kasita bali bangambyeko sisobola zaala.
Now, brethren, on my prayer card, I never wrote that I'm barren because I knew that this is something hereditary. In our kingdom, in our home, we never produce. We are all barren from my family. After getting married, I spent 20 years barren. I told him, you know, my father told you I cannot produce children because I was serving demons back home.
Kati ne mugamba sebo mbadde nsaba tufuneyo mukazi asobole kutuzalirako ku baana.
I request you to get a woman who can produce for us children.
Nze ndi rende kubalabirira bulungi nga sekwasiza.
Me I'm ready to take care of those children with no excuse.
Kati mwami wange nagamba kakati nze mbanjagala gobo munonya.
And my husband told me, I want you to look out for the woman.
Kati nafuna mukwano gwange yuno wano ku kifanani.
I got my friend and here she is in the photo.
Bamita Janine Mbolu.
She's called Janine Ngolu.
Nenjogera naye ne mugamba.
I talked to her and I told her.
Nze mbade njagala mama wange akuwase.
I want my husband to marry you.
Osobole kumuzalirako kubana. Nje njabala biratofayo.
That you may produce for him children. Don't worry me, I will take care of the children.
Ono mchala,
now this woman
oboya akiriza netugenda noli madami netugenda netu nebamu sasula yo.
So this lady accepted. I went with the other sister and they paid dowry to her parents.
Natandika kuzala nze ngantwala bana.
She started producing. Whichever child she would produce, I would take the child.
Kati bino bifanani wano ono baby girl otasobode kuja wano ye bamuletera nga ingana wano kati ye mukazi mukulu ina miaka 16 na etasobode kuja.
This is the baby. She was apparently she's 16 years old. They brought her to me when she was 1 year. This is my first child whom they first gave to me. This is the second born. This is my third born.
Kati oli asembayo eriyo mwana wakuna.
The other one is the fourth born.
Ono galo nabera asembayo.
And this is the last born.
Naye wana bange bwambi mugenda kunsonywa kasatwagala kwa Yesu bujulizi ne kumwachitibwa naye sinze mbazala.
My children, please forgive me. I've come to testify and thank Jesus for what he did for me, but truly I am not your mother.
It is today they know that you're not their mom.
Lelo abana bano rebategedde nti toli mama wabwe.
Era tetubagamba ngako kujako nga abaina ngeri gye bawuliramu.
No, we have never told all these children about this secret.
Kati ono ye tata wange kabaka.
Now brethren, this is a photograph showing my father. My father is a king.
Naye yafa.
But he died.
Kino kye kifaananyi kyabo nga bali mu somero.
This is a photograph.
Nga bali ku somero wano.
When they were at school, they were still young babies. I didn't know that I'm not her son.
Nze nsomye from primary paka nimaze university. Mama wangu tambulianga kwa tuwae siye mama wangu buchimwa bada chimba mubude school fees.
Nasikia huruma sana.
I feel sorry.
Jaba mjomba.
I'm their uncle.
Ni vizuri sana.
It's good.
Mutu kusema kweli.
It's for someone to say the truth.
Kuliko kusema uongo.
Other than saying lies.
Mpulide bubi na ye. Nze mama kubya nkolede nze simanyo baisiye mama wange nze gwentwala ntiye anzala.
I felt bad, but according to what my mother has done for me, I know her as my mother.
We should all put a hand to Jesus for this woman's life.
Ndowoza fenaka tukubira Yesu mungalo
twebase for her life.
Twebase Yesu olwobula mu bomchalo ono.
She has a good heart.
Alina mutima omulungi.
For somebody to be taking care of someone else's children
without
letting them know she has the heart of gold.
Thank God for what you are. And again, thank God for the people who have tried to make it for you.
Era webaze Katonda olwa bantu abafubi okulabanga bakikukolera okutuuka awo woli. I'm amazed and surprised at that woman. Of all the women I see, she's a woman among women. Man of God, I am a jealous woman.
And
I cannot surrender my husband.
Praise Jesus.
Yes, we have a Zibwe.
My name is Ngahingahi Rogers.
Mpitiwa Ngahingahi Rogers.
And I'm the firstborn.
Nze firstborn.
In this family.
Mufamire no.
From today I've learned one thing.
Le okuva lero njize chintu chimu.
Forgiveness.
Kusonyiwa.
God bless your life.
Katonda kuwa mukisa.
God will take you abroad.
Katonda kutwale nebweru.
Abulugana mkama ebazibwe.
Praise the Lord, brethren.
Amanya kengeze Ngahingahi Mike.
I'm Mike Ngahingahi. I want to thank my mother.
She's one in a million.
One in a million people. Basing on the way she has been treating us and caring for us, we all knew that she's our real mother. But it's today that we've known that she's not our mother. But as for me, I will continue loving her as my only mother.
I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. I know the plans.
This is 5 million. I only want to thank you. It is a sign of thanks for being a good mom for us. Go and thank the
mom.
No one whose hope is in Jesus Christ is hopeless. The intervention of Jesus Christ in the case of this family demonstrates the unconditional love of God unto his children. Although Letu Sabe Salama had kept it to herself, knowing that barrenness was part of her and a family curse, the love of God proved that with God all things are possible. Today, Sister Tusabe Salama is singing with joy and raising her banner of victory, for she's now a mother among mothers. Praise the Lord.
Now, people that you have seen this,
Katiabo Luganda, ngabe mulabye chino.
It is a simple example to Jesus. He did what people couldn't do for us. That is why we should love him more. Look the way he intervened in this case. So the same way, he will now intervene in your case, you people. Say, Lord Jesus, the way you intervened, the same way, my issue, I'm waiting for you. Thank you.